Prodigal Steve returns to Stardew Valley. How's it going, everybody? Last episode was quite productive, actually. This episode, we apparently have the Festival of Ice. So, 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. tomorrow. Which means anything that we want to accomplish, we need to do today, basically. We learned how to cook plum pudding. That's exciting. I do have some things on the docket today. Hello there, Steve. So, your first year in Stardew Valley is almost over, huh? If you keep buying seeds from me, you'll be twice as productive next year. And I have some exciting news. I'll be selling new seed varieties in my shop next year. I should have one new variety per season. Well, that's all I wanted to say. Have a good one. That's actually quite interesting. You know, I wouldn't even bother trying my competitor seeds. Pure seeds are the highest quality seeds you'll find anywhere. That's a promise. Look, dude, you're the only person I buy seeds from. You know this. Dear Steve, tomorrow we're all gathering in front of Marnie's house for the ice, or for the Festival of Ice. It's a celebration of winter. There'll be snowmen, ice sculptures, and an ice fishing competition. Arrive between 9 a.m. and 2 p.m. if you'd like to participate. Mayor Lewis. Okay. I actually forgot that it was down by Marnie's place, so that's good to know. Let's go ahead and check on our chickens here. Yeah, let's see. Last episode, we actually got a couple of bundles finished, and we managed to finish an entire room as well, so our greenhouse is completed. And pretty high on our docket today is acquiring an apple tree to plant in said greenhouse. So that we can finish this bundle. We need pigs for this. We need ducks and red cabbage. Still need the tiger trout, which I have no idea how to catch, and the eel, which I think is an ocean fish that can only be caught at night. I have not caught one in this file anyway. It'd be like here, I think. I am just gonna turn all this milk into cheese. And now let's not forget to feed our cows today. Would be unfortunate, especially not now that they're giving us large milk. That'd be a touch disrespectful. Our forage is coming in nicely. I might want to take this tree down as well, now that I'm looking at it. I don't know. We should be okay. Everything in here looks fine. Once this stuff over here comes in, I'm going to transfer these sprinklers into the greenhouse. Because I refuse to water crops in the greenhouse. Like, it is silly and unnecessary. Can we get our, what's the word? Our watering can back today, or do we have to wait a day for that? We might have to wait, so we might not actually even be able to get it back at all this episode, depending on if we can get to Clint's or not. But we might as well head over there and check. I do want to go to Pierre's and also visit the traveling merchant today as well. So we actually have a fair amount of stuff that we need to accomplish here today. Locked. Right, okay. Well, let's go check the beach real quick. Even though we don't need shells for any of our remaining bundles, they're still worth selling. Plus, we could find some more roots or worms or whatever to dig up and perhaps find something to donate to Gunther. A lot of errands today, and I think perhaps next episode then... Oh, we're just rolling in Nautilus shells now. Perhaps next episode we'll head back to the Skull Cavern? Make another go at that? Yeah, we have already donated that. Okay, nothing really exciting down here. I mean, the Gold Star Nautilus is nice. We can go ahead and sell that to Willy here while we're at the beach. Then we'll head up to Clint's. See if we can't find our, or collect our watering can. I don't know why I keep forgetting the name of that. I'm just completely blanking here today. I apologize for that. Then we'll go to Pierre's, see if we can't get at least one apple tree. I don't think I need more than one. But I'll probably get, like, two different kinds of trees. But they are kind of pricey, so we'll have to maybe wait and see on that one a little bit. All right. Good news? Not good news. This is fine. I was pretty sure that's what was going to happen, but figured I might as well check anyway. All this stuff can just go, well, except for the copper, can just go into our shipping container once we get back to the farm. Perhaps we'll have a quest today as well. And it is Carolyn's birthday today. I need a diamond. Yeah, you know what? Why not? That's a ton of money. Okay. Let's come in here. How's it going? You can have actually all of that stuff. Apple sapling. Takes 28 days to produce a mature apple tree. Okay, that's fine. We definitely want that. And what else do we want? Let's go with pomegranate. It's a little bit pricier, but out of these available trees, I think pomegranate is probably my personal favorite. Although orange is close. Orange is probably like my least favorite citrus fruit, though, thinking about it. Like lemons, top tier. Right below that, limes. Right below that, oranges. Let's go ahead and grab a couple of diamonds. One for Carolyn for her birthday. And then one for Elliot, because he asked for one. And that'll help offset some of the costs of our trees here. Not by much, but enough. And I'm not worried about just sort of handing away diamonds, because we are constantly making more of them. Like, we have four of them just sitting here, and another one on its way, so I'm gonna go ahead and do this as well. I think, all right, that can go in there. Let's do our trees here real quick. Now, it might seem like I'm planting these in the wrong spot. Oh, they can't be planted here anymore. Oh, okay. They changed that. In my other file, I have trees planted all along these edges here. But apparently you can no longer do this. Huh. Okay. Well, let's see, this will be a sprinkler, and then this would theoretically be a sprinkler. But this row is actually going to be trees now. And I think you have to give them two spaces in between, but I'm not sure. Let's just plant in the corners for now. I probably should have planted, like, right here instead, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. Well, that's fine. Maybe those, maybe I'll actually just plant trees out here somewhere in the future, now that we can't kind of, like, scum it up. All right, let's head down to the traveling merchant, and then we'll head in and talk to, Elliot and Carolyn. Not necessarily in that order, but probably, since I suspect we'll be going in via the beach. Okay. That's not what I wanted. So I'm having trouble, like, double, like, quick-clicking it to get through like I'm accustomed to. Must just, have been operator error. What's up? Baked fish, cranberry candy. Alright. Salmon dinner, battery pack. Not overly interested in any of this stuff, honestly. So let's head down, see if we can't find Elliot. Can't believe... Well, I mean, I can believe that they fixed the tree thing, because it didn't make any sense at all. But still. Well, I'm a little, disappointed. Alright, more garbage that we can just, straight up sell. Alright. Head down to the beach. Oh, nope. Don't even have to go all the way to the beach. What's up, Elliot? Ah, the diamond I requested. And it's a beautiful one, too. Thank you very much, Steve. You are quite welcome. I really should scrub my floorboards today. I think an algae is starting to form. Do you make time for cleaning? I mean, I try to. Although, admittedly, there isn't much to clean on the farm at present. Now, Carolyn should be home. Let's see if we can't... Oh, we should probably, like, take our gold, huh? If she's not home, I honestly have no idea where she might be. Huh. Well, I can assure you that she isn't at Joja Mart. Maybe she's up by the fountain? I think she goes and hangs out there sometimes. Like, she's friends with Jody, so if she weren't hanging out here, I don't know. Ah, yeah, there she is. Hey, happy birthday. A birthday gift? That's very kind of you. I love it. I'm glad. You know what? You should just relax and think positively on your birthday. I think that's a good plan. All right. I was going to go talk to Robin and see about upgrading our coop and our barn. Obviously not at the same time, but sometime this winter I would like to do that. But instead, I think we can actually just say hi to Pam. Yeah, well, it happens. Sell this stuff, and then I think clean out our chest over here. Oh, there we go. Another diamond. As expected. All right. Well, that we want to hang on to. You know what? Let's take all of this stuff out and put it in the chest in here. Just do a little bit of cleaning, because if we're going to be heading into the mine here tomorrow, we're going to want this stuff taken care of. Yeah, we're gonna need the inventory space in that chest. Well, okay, it's not gonna be tomorrow actually. Now that I'm thinking about it, because there's the ice festival, right? I guess we could just stand here and like do a bunch of seeds, but that's a little boring. So let's move along. Is there anything else in here that we want to sell? I don't think so. Like, I kind of want all of this stuff. But I think when we head to the mine next episode, we will bring these bombs with us. I'm going to bring Solar Essence down to the wizard real quick, because I don't really have any other plans for today. I wonder if maybe I don't plant trees over here. Because, like, this section is going to be plenty large enough to feed our animals, I would expect. Plus, we can just grow grass between the trees. That's going to be no problem. Should be able to make it to the wizard in time. Because I don't like the idea, necessarily, of taking up greenhouse space with trees. Although maybe it'd be fine, because they will, once they're mature, they'll produce year-round in the greenhouse. So that might be worth it, because they'll produce like 3 fruits every day, I think. It's like we'll get 3 apples and 3 pomegranates etc., etc., every single day. You know, let's try and fish here real quick. Can I get it? Nope. Alright, well that's fine. I don't know if we can catch eels in the winter, but we might as well head to the beach and try for it. I kind of took care of all the errands and stuff that I wanted to take care of. Hopefully, first thing tomorrow, we can go and pick up our watering can from Clint, but I doubt it. We should be able to access town, but I don't know if he'll be there, is the problem. So, we may actually just be out of luck in this episode for getting our watering can back. Not that we need it just yet, but it would be nice to have it back in the event that I want to plant some more seeds in our greenhouse. Alright, some seaweed. That's going in the fridge. Make some maki rolls. Any second now. Oh. Okay. Expected a little bit more fight out of this one, but this is fine, I guess. Herring. I think do one more cast and then we'll head in. Not sure if we can even catch eels during the winter. Be nice if I could just, like, inquire to Willy about it. But, alright, that's fine. Couple of quality fish that are just immediately gonna get sold. We're gonna be doing plenty of fishing tomorrow, actually, because we are absolutely gonna participate in the ice fishing competition. So, it's exciting. Abigail's still out and about. And it'll be nice, because we'll actually get to talk to all of our villagers as well, so I'm looking forward to that. A little bit offbeat episode, though. This is like 2 days in a row now that we've just done kind of like chore stuff. But that's alright, that'll change next episode. And I did want to take some time off of the mine anyway, because I don't want every single episode to be exactly the same here in the winter. Not a whole lot of gold there, but, you know, 300 gold's better than nothing. Alright, 8th of winter, year one. What do we got for the weather? Clear and sunny all day. Fortune teller. Very happy today, alright? Living off the land. Find any tree seeds, we'll chop in wood. You can plant these in the ground, and yes, I'm familiar with the concept of growing new trees. Oh, we have some beer and some mail. Dear Steve, nothing's more satisfying than cooking with fresh vegetables from your own garden. I've enclosed a recipe to help you out. Take care, Caroline. Parsnip soup. Hey, thank you. Oh, more mail. Hey, kid, here's the recipe for a little treat my pappy used to make. Cook it slow, Pam. New recipe, stuffing. All right, everybody's sending me recipes today. That's exciting. Alrighty, make some more beer. And this beer can go in there. Let's go see our animals. Morning. Morning. Only one egg today, apparently. A little suspicious, but it's fine. We got some cheese here. I should keep the milk, actually. No milk, huh? Is it just every other day? No. Huh. Wonder what your problem is then. You look fine. Interesting. Might as well make some more gold star cheese. Which will get sold. I think this other cheese is actually going to go into the fridge. I fed all my animals, right? Yes. Okay. I was pretty sure I had, but, you know, after forgetting that one time, I'm doubting myself now. What's up, Dud? Alright, what do we got? You know, we should make some gold bars here. We're gonna need them for something. Alright, got some more seeds as well. No point in not doing this. Now, how many cranberry seeds do we have? 41. That's a ton. Alright. Everything's looking fine in here. Alright, so far so good. And it is almost time for the festival. Let's come in here real quick. Store this cheese. We have plenty of mayo. I should just bring some milk into the fridge and some eggs, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, because we're definitely going to need those for various recipes. I suspect we won't be able to go to Pierre's today, but it's worth trying. I'm going to pop over to Clint's real quick. Presumably we can get there. Okay. I expect that he's just going to be closed, though. Yep. Okay. Well, that's fine. Let's go back to the bus stop. Let's grab this last piece of forage over here. And then we'll dump all of this stuff in the shipping container, and then head on to our event. And it'll be a little bit shorter episode today. Okay, there we go. I figured it out. I almost want to, like, double up this path, but I don't want to take up too much room. Alright, here we go. What's up, Elliot? I'm entering the ice fishing competition today. Why not? That's a good attitude. It's rare that Willy ever loses, though. Oh, that's going to change today. Oh, ice. A beautiful material to sculpt in, but so impermanent. Yep. But I guess that might make the art even better. There you go. It's a good thought process. I'm sorry, but carving ice parapets requires my undivided attention. I can imagine. The forest looks beautiful in the winter, doesn't it? Man, I'm having all sorts of trouble reading today. How's winter coming along for you, Steve? A little eclectic, but good, all in all. If it was up to me, I'd probably have a pizza festival at the saloon instead. Shane, you're a man after my own heart. Wife dragged me out into the cold for this? Why are you so grumpy all the time? Did I ever tell you how George and I first met? He actually pelted me with a snowball at this very festival. He was a gentleman back then and came over to see if I was okay. Aw, George. I'm not very creative when it comes to snowmen. It's fine. What do you think of my snow goon? I think it looks, fantastic. The snow is so cold, I can't feel my fingers anymore. Dude, it's called gloves. Pierre, wear some gloves. I guess winter isn't all bad. Playing in the snow can be fun. This is correct. Snowmen are okay, I guess, but mostly I'm looking forward to the spring. I'm okay with winter so far. I plan on winning the ice fishing competition. Willie's gonna be pretty hard to beat, though. He does this kind of stuff day and night. We should collude, Pam, to take him down. Emily started helping me without any provocation. Does this mean something? Wow, the snowman needs a makeover. Who made this? That's a little rude. I want to give him a carrot nose. Fair enough. What kind of snowman should we make? Classic one, carrot nose, top hat, scarf, something funky, icicle antennas, pine cone eyes. Snowmen are boring, or think outside the box. You know, why not something funky? Okay, sounds like fun. See, there we go. Be a little creative with it. You know what? I probably should have worn a jacket. Yeah, maybe. Hey, Steve, ready for some ice fishing? Yes, I'll do my best. That's the spirit. I like Willy. Extreme temperatures can put your body under a lot of stress, so make sure to bundle up. Yo, go tell Demetrius that. Oh, and enjoy the festival. Sorry there's no food. Dude, it's fine, man. Just wait until the Feast of the Winter Star. You'll be stuffed for days. I'm looking forward to it. I feel bad for all the poor cold animals out there. I mean, they have fur. Like, they're acclimated to living in the cold. They wouldn't be in this climate if they weren't. Saw a big fish down there. Alright. Cold? Nah, I never get cold. Hey Steve, are you gonna enter the ice fishing competition? Absolutely. Oh, not me. I don't know how to fish. It's fairly simple. Alright, I think that's everybody, which means we could probably get the fishing competition started. Wait, hang on, where's Linus? Linus? Why wouldn't you come hang out with us, man? Oh, he's gotta be around here somewhere, right? No Marlin either. I like that all of the trees and also all of the detritus is gone. There you are! What's up, man? Igloo building's an art I picked up from the tundra dwellers who live beyond the frozen sea. That was many years ago. An igloo makes a nice home, but it's easier to just stay in my tent year-round. Fair enough. That is information I did not have about you. I can't get up to the wizard. Although it claims that I can speak with him. Yo, Linus. Let me pass your igloo, though. I gotta go talk to the wizard. Is Marlin around here? I don't think I've ever found Linus at this festival before. Huh. Well, there we go. We learned something today. Anybody over here on the dock? Nope. Traveling merchant is obviously gone. Alright, well, I guess that's everybody. Alright, Lewis, let's do this. Yes, ice fishing competition. I am absolutely ready to compete. Yes. Come at me. I'm a fishing machine. I like that everybody else starts by a pond except me. Gotta handicap me. Many fish as possible in 2 minutes. Okay. Everyone basically gets like a free fish on me, which is unfortunate, but not insurmountable. Alright. Easy does it. Now we can catch like seaweed and like algae and stuff, so we want to be mindful of that. Alright, so we're at 2. I think we're tied with Willy and Pam right now, but I suspect that I will lose count on how everybody else is doing relatively quickly. Just furiously click my mouse to skip the holding above my head animation. Oh, Alex! I apparently didn't talk to him. Did I see Alex anywhere? I don't know. I should have had that fish perfectly. So, that's my bad. Still have about a minute left. We could get like 8 fish, maybe. Well, that's probably gonna hamper that possibility. I love this music because it sort of sounds like the Romani Ranch from Legend of Zelda. Just a little bit. Or like, I guess the Lon Lon Ranch. Either or. I always default to the Majora's Mask names for things because that's my preferred game, controversial as that may be. I actually think Majora's Mask is a better game than Ocarina of Time. I like it quite a bit more. Alright, if we catch another fish real quickly, we could get 8. Oh, come on. Nope. That's alright, 7 might be good enough. A lot of fish. This is correct. The spell. Lewis is apparently not a fisherman. Now, for the winner of this year's ice fishing competition... Steve with 7 big slimy fish. That's right. Here's your prize. Enjoy. Oh, I got actually like a bunch of stuff. Sailor's hat, yes. Well, that's it for this year's festival advice. Thanks for coming, everyone. Now, let's release these poor fish. Have fun, man. Maru, I didn't talk to? Huh. I can't believe I won. Well, time to head home. Alright, well, for now, we're gonna go ahead and put the sailor's cap on. It's a little goofy what it did to my hair there, but that's fine. Don't need to do anything over here. I have no idea what I'm gonna do with all of this stuff. Because I can't put any of it on the rod that we presently have. So I guess that can all just go in there. Yeah, the sailor's cap's gotta come off. It makes me look like I have a mullet, and that is something I cannot abide. Let's go check, yeah, these gold bars, etc. We should probably make some copper bars, actually, since that's one thing that we're lacking. I just want to have this stuff smelted up, basically. Ooh, and we can actually make another life elixir. So that's exciting. Might as well craft that real quick since we're going to need it next episode. Actually, yeah, let's do this first. That was completely unnecessary. I figured we'll do that and then we'll have the seeds to put back in the chest, but we're not actually going to have those. Might as well do some more copper bars now, huh? I just want to make sure that we have, like, at least 5 bars of everything in case we need them for any construction projects, basically. Because I will be looking into upgrading our buildings and so forth here. But for now, that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, consider hitting the like button. As always, feedback is welcome in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to the channel. And I will see you next time.